Brett Button, the bus driver who crashed and killed 10 people in the Hunter Valley, was under the influence of a prescription painkiller at the time of the tragedy. The shocking new details emerged on a devastating day for the families of his victims, outraged by a plea deal that saw manslaughter charges dropped.
Shielded by supporters, but unable to hide from the anger surrounding his legal handshake.
Some of the families are furious at this plea deal. What do you have to say to them?
Brett Button hung his head while answering guilty to 35 of the 89 charges. 10 counts of manslaughter dropped in exchange for a confession to dangerous driving occasioning death.
This is not anger, it's not revenge, it's justice. Everybody's been let down. And you know what? You don't call me 36 hours beforehand.
The bus crash at Greta last June was described by first responders like a war zone. 10 passengers killed, dozens injured, all on their way home from a wedding. The majority of the victims' families were willing to endure the trauma of a trial in their fight for justice. But Matt and Leanne Mullen claim they were blindsided when informed about the backflip on Monday, told it's done. They said hearing it today was even worse. Their criticism not of the solicitors, but of the decision makers for backing down. The Attorney General now demanding a briefing from the Director of Public Prosecutions.
Nobody in this place wants to see family members and victims displeased with or re-traumatised by the criminal justice system.
A police document seen by the Sydney Morning Herald states Button had likely ingested 400 milligrams of the prescription painkiller tramadol in the 24 hours before the tragedy. It was found the opioid would have impacted his capacity behind the wheel, even with tolerances after years of addiction.
Button's freedom has now come to an end. Tonight he's in prison where he's asked to be treated for anxiety and depression. Despite the devastation of his plea deal for some of the families, one father has still found some compassion for the man who killed his daughter.
Our hearts and thoughts also with the family of the wife as well.
Button faces court again this month, this time from behind bars. Tiffany Genders, 9 News.